What's up guys, it's Oakelfish or Oakley here, and today I've got for you guys a questions and answers video with my brother here, sat on the left of me. His name is Huey. Huey, do you want to say hello?
Yeah, what's up guys?
There we go. That wasn't so hard, now was it? That was decent. So basically guys, we're going to be answering your questions that you've asked on Twitter and on Facebook. We're going to get on with it right now, hopefully it's going to be a good laugh. And so yeah, let's crack on. Chris Collins or at Chris underscore Collins asks, what's the best joke you know? Do you have any jokes on the top of your head?
No.
You're not a joker?
Not naturally.
Do you know what a shih tzu is?
A dog?
No, it's a zoo with no animals. Mate, that is comedy gold. It's a zoo with no animals, do you get it? Shit,
I
zoo?
I do get that, yeah.
Okay, sorry mate, just like to slow things down for you a little bit
there. Shih tzu though, could be like, have terrible animals. Mice and stuff.
Mice are a pretty cool animal. Matty or at underscore Matty Jones asks, who's the strongest out of you two?
I'm not gonna lie, it's okay.
Yeah. Got two guns. Billy and Jacob.
You just ruined it.
Andrew or at Sinner Ninja asks, which of you was the favourite sons?
Me.
Huey. Bob Smith or at Arsenal Fan 111. Are you quite done on your phone?
I didn't know you were recording.
Well, it's been on. When there's a red dot, it's recording. You see that thing up there?
Now I can, but from this angle.
When you press the button that says start recording. Okay. How is Huey Jamaican and Oakley you're not? Not sure where you got your
facts from.
Got your facts. We're finishing each other's sentences, yeah. Yes. Not. Burn! Don't sit down! Sit down, mate! Come on. Come on. I'll give you one now. No, I promise.
Don't want it.
I promise. Just do it. Don't. Yeah, yeah. There we go. See, wait, that was me! There we go. Mate, I'm not sure where you got your facts from, but the credibility of this fact is wrong. It's just wrong, man.
Got the same parents.
We've got exactly the same parents. Exactly the same dad, exactly the same mother.
Just he turned out white with curly hair.
Yeah, and you turned out like darkish
metallic
with
brown.
Like metallic brown is not a colour for
that's
skin.
What it is.
Dad doesn't know what he's talking about then.
It's facts.
Huey, it goes white, brown, black. You're brown. It's non-negotiable. Deal with it, you twat! Quarter American, quarter English, quarter Irish. We're like a cocktail of so much shit. Yeah. All muddled words are a cocktail. What was that smile, you freak? What was that?
Just great banter.
It really is. Great banter. Chez or at Cheryl Gart asks, at what age did you lose your virginity?
Not my virgin.
This lad, H-Dog, is a member of V-Town.
Yeah,
and fair play, fair play, he's waiting for the right girl to come along, aren't you, Huey?
Yeah.
Which is what everyone else should do. The party boss, or at the party boss, asks, if you had to shag one, which one would you go for, an anorexic girl or an obese girl? I personally would go anorexic.
That's just the question no one wants to be asked,
though,
isn't it?
Well, to be honest with you,
I mean, you'd hope not to be in that situation.
Well, I mean, like, obviously, I'd hope they have a little. They're anorexic, they still have to have, obviously, some muscle to walk and stuff. But, like, a really obese person would just be so disgusting. Like, to have sex, you'd have to, like, lift, like, their flubber.
Oh, that is. Yeah.
But imagine how sweaty it would be. Imagine it. Imagine licking their sweat.
Yeah, could you do that? Yeah.
No, I wouldn't do that. And also, if you had sex with an anorexic girl, you'd have a very high likelihood of putting her in a wheelchair after.
Another disgusting.
Mate, that would be sick! Imagine that, then I'd say, yeah.
I don't know about sick.
I shagged a girl, and she ended up in a wheelchair.
Alright, good line, yeah.
I've got a tab with the NHS, family wheelchairs that are rolling out. That would be incredible!
Alright, that's a decent line, but.
Yeah, there we go.
That's about
anorexic.
It. Anorexic, yeah.
You got anorexic as well?
I swayed my
opinion. I swayed it?
Yeah.
Yes, go me! Tom Parsons or at Tom Parsnips asks, what's the baddest thing you and your brother have ever done? We haven't really done anything that terrible before. I mean, we smashed, I guess looking back at it was pretty like harsh. We didn't realise how bad it was at the time because we were younger, but we were playing like catch or something in the house and knocked over one of my mum's like figurative indoor decorations, like a sculpture thing. That was pretty bad and that broke, so I guess that's pretty harsh, but other than that, we were wrongly accused whilst on a golf course. And Huey, how old are you? Like,
I was just with you, I wasn't doing anything.
Yeah, well, nor was I. But, no, but I mean, like, we got pulled over for, like, being disruptive on a golf course. We didn't get pulled over, I don't know, we were in a car, we were just, like, running. And as we were running, I may have kicked some of the golf balls, like, that were on the field, like, on the fairway. And obviously the golfers got pretty, like, pissed off with that. And the police happened to be around. In fact, they weren't even real policemen, I don't think. They were like PCSOs, which all they can actually do is put you under civil arrest. So they did that.
I'm still scared.
Yeah, but like you were like, I'm pretty sure he was like 7 or 8, so.
I didn't know what was going on.
And I was meant to be looking after him, so I was just like crapping myself because I thought, oh crap, my mom's gonna kill me. But it turns out that I think we managed to swing it to say that they were being like racially prejudiced like towards us or something, and she just completely dropped it. That was actually quite funny. So we worked there really well, actually. Yeah, I just remember that's how we got out of it. So we did. That's like a plan, man. That's a plot. That's been. How old are you now? That's like 7 years ago.
Yeah.
We are very good. Just a girl or at Rachel Garland 95 asks at Oakelfish, how are you today? And what's the worst Christmas present you've ever got? I am absolutely fantastic. The weather's pretty shitty though. And yourself? How are you, Huey?
But
he's all, yeah, agree on weather. Agree on the weather front. We should be like weathermen, really.
Possibly.
I don't know why, because we're just stating that the weather's shit. But it's raining in England as usual. But yeah, we're absolutely fantastic. The worst Christmas present I've ever got. I'll let you do yours first.
On the spot, I can't think of anything.
You can't think of anything.
No. Give me time to think this,
like. I can remember one year, oh, I can remember yours, a sick present you got. Somehow this guy
this
managed to
worst.
Swing.
That's going off the question.
No, it's fine. I'm gonna go to what your best was so you can revert back. This is giving you time to think about your worst. He once got a flipping mountain bike in a stocking. Like, how does that actually work? Do you remember that? It wasn't even wrapped up as a present, it was next to your stocking. And I had a fucking cassette player.
No, I can't even.
I had a tape cassette player. Do you know how many tapes they made? Like four. Yes. I got seriously
screwed. What's your worst
then? My worst, £10 Woolworths voucher.
Oh yeah,
a £10 Woolworths voucher. Who shops in Woolworths?
WH Smiths.
Have you ever shopped in Woolworths? It doesn't even exist anymore. Nobody shopped in it.
That's how bad it was.
It was terrible. It's called like Peacocks or something now. A terrible name for a shop. What's your actual worst? I bet you cannot
be. It would be a £5 WH Smiths voucher.
Yeah, but who buys that? Like, what do you buy with that? Like,
Karen, apparently.
Pick a mix. Pick a mix. That's what you buy with that. Flipping pick a mix. Reese McCullough, or at Reese MCC98, asks, if you could time travel back in time, what would you change about your life? This is pretty.
It's quite a deep question.
It's quite a deep question, man. I don't think. Well, I mean, obviously, I'd go back to like a day where I knew what the lottery numbers were, or I'd go back to a day where I knew there was like several football games on that I knew the results. So I'd just become like incredibly rich. I wouldn't actually. I don't think I regret anything I've done in my life, because like you learn from your mistakes and stuff. And you're kind of too young to really have any major mistakes. I haven't really done much of yourself, have you? Vanessa B or at Van BZK asks, why did you get your nose pierced? The answer to which is, this is obviously directed at me, the answer to which is that I just fancied getting something pierced. I had my ear pierced, but I hated it, took that out. I wanted to get my eyebrow done, but I wasn't allowed, and I wasn't rebellious as a child. So, yeah, that would kill. I actually saw one of my friends get it done, they like passed out. It was actually quite funny.
Why especially did you get your nose done?
Did you?
Yeah.
That's when I got it redone. Yeah, that it really hurts sometimes. Mm. That makes your eyes water for sure. But there's no real reason behind why I did it. But would you get anything pierced?
Yeah, maybe, but not like
again, cartilage. What about Prince Albie?
Definitely not. You put the image in my head.
Why? What about Albie? No. cheeky one? Apparently the females love it.
How?
You tell me.
You don't want to go into that.
You don't want to go into it?
That's just disgusting.
You don't want to penetrate this conversation?